like we are ready to get this thing in to right there.
It's, I don't know.
The day has arrived.
We're getting close.
The day has arrived. I mean, it's off the bench in one piece and sitting right beside the motorcycle.
It's off the bench. It's out of the stand.
And we have the hardware right here.
Yep. Yeah.
That's all. Okay.
These spacers go actually in between.
Uh-huh.
So the frame, the motor sits right here. And that bolt goes through.
Okay.
Through these spacers and through the motor. I don't know how easy that one's going to be, but...
Well, we're going to find out in a minute.
We're going to find out in a minute here.
So well, let's...
I'm almost wondering if it might be easier to go in from that side than this side because of this.
Oh. Oh, yeah, you might be right. You might be right. Okay, so the motor is sitting in the bike. Yep.
Yeah, I think we're going to have to...
It's going to have to be manipulated
a little bit.
Got the swing arm went right in. It came through the driver's side. They're both the driver's side. It came through the left side of the motorcycle. And everything looks really good.
We're getting closer to making this thing actually
live.
We need a chain. We need some exhaust. We need a little bit of wiring. Some cables.
You know, they said if you could do this, you could do anything, right? And so I said, "You mean I could make a screwdriver fly?" And they're like, "Yes, you can." Make a screwdriver fly.
You gotta love that. I think we're running out of parts here. The boxes that...
These are the crates that came with the motorcycle, and they were full of what was left of the motor.
They're no longer there.
Now we're just about out of parts. You can see we've got some exhaust pieces on the ground. A muffler right there.
Another muffler.
Oh, that's not the one we're going to run.
Well, I think that might be the one we'll start with.
Oh, okay.
And then this is the...
And then we'll go to the big gun.
This big gun...
That's the big gun setup.
Yeah, I've got to do some... A little bit more
and
work
this,
on it.
We've got this here, and it's going to require some modifications.
Yeah, this is the factory skid plate.
Factory skid plate, aftermarket skid plate. We're going to put the aftermarket on there, but we're going to have to... Again, do some modifications, but the bike is, man, it looks like a rider right now. So we've got the exhaust to put on and,
some cables,
put gas in the tank, hook it up and ride off into the sunset. But today, well, we'd ride it in the rain. It doesn't matter. It's raining a little bit today. Okay. KTM project. Take one. Okay, here we go. We're going to check for spark. Check for spark. You ready?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Well, bada boom, bada bing. That thing sounds like it's got good compression, too. You hear it?
We got spark.
Okay, we got spark.
I'm going to put this plug back here.
The first thing you need is spark. It's always the first thing. Then fuel.
What's that famous...
Suck, bang, blow?
Yeah.
Well, there's something else in there too.
One in there.
Squeeze. Suck, squeeze,
suck,
bang, blow.
Suck, squeeze, bang, blow.
Yep. Suck, squeeze, bang, blow. Yep.
That's it.
Oh, it's in there. It's in there. Unbelievable. So are we going to start this with a little bit of ether or...
I think I'll try to put some fuel in it.
Okay. Did it sound like it?
Oh my God!
That was only one carb full of gas. I recommend anybody who does stuff like this is to get something like this with a little thing here. That way you can squirt it in a carburetor. You know, I just basically took it like this and ran it in here and filled the carburetor like that. You know?
Unbelievable.
And that enabled us to start and run for, you know, at least a carburetor full. And you can even, if you like, you run your car out of gas or you're starting a car for the first time, like a four-barrel Holley, or most four barrels for that matter, you can put this in the vent tube and fill the bowl through the vent tube. You know, you can't overfill it, so you got to be careful. So, you know, you just have an idea of how much goes in there and put at least half that much in there to get it started and get that fuel pump kicking. But anyways, there you go. You have the first start, second kick, first start on the KTM 620 project.
We got to get some couple other things buttoned up, a couple other issues, but now that it runs, hey, button up these babies and we'll get you a first ride.
We're going to be doing first ride action very soon.
Yes.
There's a couple other little things that need to be tweaked on the bike, but it's ready to go.
What I did notice
was
things were lit up.
Lights, oh, that's good.
Lights were working.
I didn't even look. I was so excited
this
about the whole
This was working.
Thing.
It was. I was kind of shocked that it actually ran. It's like, yeah. Oh, crap.
I mean, she fired up and idled, too.
Yes.
No throttle. No hand on the throttle to make it idle.
No.
Awesome sauce.
Yes. Oh, good. Awesome, too.
Yeah.
Fuck yeah.
Okay, here we go. We went ahead and swapped out the radiators. If you've seen last time, the exhaust was touching the radiator there. So the bike is pretty much complete.
Oh, and I actually mounted the horn. You look at it over here on this side.
Uh-huh.
Look where the horn is.
Oh, how cute. See the horn, guys? So it's got a horn.
And it's mounted to the radiator. I mean, it's tight.
Perfect.
And the wiring sneaks through and...
Yep.
Perfect.
Okay, so let's fill them radiators up and fire this... dog up.
That's probably no, that is high. Put that cap on so we don't get fuel in there.
Oh yeah, that's a good idea. Try not to put fuel on your radiator, guys.
Yeah.
Little pro tip. You know, here in the shop series, we're there with a pro tip. Don't put fuel in your radiator. And save that for the tank.
Oh, you know what else I found out?
Uh-oh.
That thing that I thought was the choke?
Yeah.
It's actually a hot start.
Hot start?
Hot start. The choke is actually that thing that I thought was the idle adjustment.
Oh.
See, what you need to do is you need to come down here, and this thing pulls.
That's the choke.
It pulls down. Yeah, you pull it down, and you turn it.
Okay.
That's the choke.
Okay.
So, I don't know.
Right. Oh, and the fuel's on?
Nope. Not yet. I gotta look at it here and see.
Put the fuel on. It's got the super trap, factory super trap.
We'll just turn it.
Kind of, it's a super tramp.
We'll turn it to reserve.
To, okay.
So, you can turn that choke off.
Okay.
Just turn it.
Right or left?
It doesn't matter.
Oh, there we go. Okay.
It should go back up. Oh my God.
That's a day of business right there.